is up, everybody? This is Nia Pierce, editor-in-chief at SheaTech.com, and I am here with my right-hand woman and my left-hand woman. I'm going to go ahead and let my ladies introduce themselves to you. Erica, go ahead and introduce yourselves to the people and tell us what you've been gaming on, what you've been up to.
Oh, dang. What's going on, everyone? Second show, episode 2.
Yeah, level two. We're leveling. We're using levels instead of episodes, guys. Shout out to Kenny for that. He came up with that.
We're past the pilot stage.
Yes.
But yeah, you guys, I'm happy to be doing this again. I'm excited for this episode. What have I been playing? A lot of Battlefield. That's for sure. I just got Ratchet and Clank.
Yes. So
I'm starting that. Yeah. So
that's a great game. Ratchet and Clank is
yes.
Good. It's cool so far.
Good.
I'm enjoying it.
You're really going to enjoy that game. That's a really good game.
Oh, I love that game. Let's go ahead and let her finish her intro. We can talk about it.
I'm trying to think of the other games I've been playing. Mostly those and Titanfall here and there. A couple games. But yeah, there's so many games out right now. I'm just trying to juggle everything.
Yeah.
But yeah, let's get into these topics. I'm excited.
All right, Jaleesa, go ahead and introduce yourself to the people. Let them know what you've been gaming on and what's been going on with you.
What's going on, people? Y'all already know who it is. It's your favorite gamer girl, Jaleesa. And what have I been playing lately? I have been on Battlefield a little bit. I need to get back on it, but Mafia 3 kind of just stole everything, and it just sucked all the game out of me. So I've been playing a bunch of Mafia 3, and I beat it. So it was a pretty good game. I beat that. Let me see. I've been doing my Madden and my 2K. You know, I'm the only person in SheaTech who freaking loves sport games. I've been playing that. And what else? I've actually been going back and playing some of the PlayStation Plus games that I've downloaded.
Oh, nice.
I went back and played Broforce, which is actually pretty fun.
Yeah.
That's a fun game.
Yeah, I went back and played Broforce. What else did I download? Galick Z. Strider. I went back and downloaded that, played that. And Shovel Knight. I went back and downloaded
it. Yes.
I need that game.
Yeah.
Yes.
That's not a PlayStation Plus game, but it's a game that I bought and I just never went back to it. And I finally went back to it and got into that a little bit more too.
All good choices. Very good choices. So as for me, I've been playing Titanfall 2 and Paladins. I'm always playing Paladins. If any of you guys are following me on my personal social media as well as YouTube and Twitch, you'll know that that's pretty much what I've been playing. I don't really get a chance to play. What is it, babe?
No, I was gonna say, you said Titanfall 2, right?
Yes, ma'am.
I got a question. How much did y'all pay for that?
My boyfriend bought it for me, so I paid
$0. I'm just asking because they have like a deal right now. That joint is like $30.
Yeah, unfortunately, Titanfall 2 didn't do very well, ladies and gentlemen. So you're probably going to find it cheap for a little while at least. But which is actually unfortunate. I'm actually pretty sad about that. And shame on EA for bringing that game out when it did, because Titanfall 2 is actually a really good game and it's a very, very good sequel to the first Titanfall. And I know a lot of people had a lot of mixed reactions to the first Titanfall, but I enjoyed it quite a bit for what
I did. First Titanfall.
Yeah, like I enjoyed it a lot. And Titanfall 2 is a very worthy sequel, and I am so sad that EA let that game out to die, because that's exactly what they did.
Pretty much.
They let that game out to die.
Did I say something? I was like, yo, Battlefield, and even though people hate Call of Duty, that it was the wrong time to put that game
out. It got sandwiched.
It got sandwiched between some of the biggest, like two of the biggest shooters ever. Why would you do that? But anyway, this is not a EA podcast. That was actually what we were going to talk about last week, but I had some PC issues, so I apologize, because I did say on social media that we were going to be recording a new episode of Boss Lair last week, but I had some issues, so that is my bad. Send your hate mail to me. So let's go ahead and finish what we have set out for tonight. So our first topic of today is some Nintendo Switch rumors. I know we already have the reveal, but we're back to rumors again. So this is where we're at right now. So the first Nintendo Switch rumor is that The Legend of Zelda might not be a launch title, and this is a rumor according to an industry insider by the name of Emily Rogers. And a lot of people feel certain types of ways about Emily Rogers, but she's right about a lot of stuff. I mean, she's wrong about some stuff too, but she's also right about a lot of stuff. When we first heard about the NX being this hybrid console that was gonna have like these detachable controllers, Emily Rogers was one of the first people who were on that bandwagon saying, yes, this is true, this is a real thing. A lot of people call this woman crazy. Lo and behold, that is exactly what we got. That's exactly what we got. So the possibility of The Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild not being a launch title and possibly coming out in the summertime is a very real possibility. I'm going to do this round table style, and I'm going to start with Erica. Erica, what do you feel about this rumor? Do you think it's true? Do you think it's not true? And what is your reaction if this does actually happen?
Oh, man. I kind of consider this an educated rumor. Like, it has weight to it, mm-hmm. and I feel like it could be true. Just because of, you know, like you said, Emily Rogers and her track record. But I really hope it's not. I really think the Switch needs to launch with this game. We've been waiting for this game for years.
Mm-hmm.
And it's sad, too, for the people with Wii U's. They're still waiting for this game. A lot of people bought a Wii U to play this game. And it's like, where is it? You know, what's going on?
They need to bring it out already.
Yeah, and the article, pretty much the one we're looking at, is saying that the localization is far behind. Or right. Fallen behind.
Mm-hmm.
And it could be wrapping up in December, and that means it won't come out till the summer. So, honestly, I would say delay the Switch. That's how much I feel this game is very important to the Switch.
Yeah.
That's how much I think this game matters.
Right.
So that's pretty much how I feel. I think that would be best for Nintendo.
What do you think about it, Julissa?
How can I say this? I'm not the hugest of a fans of Zelda because I've really never played Zelda on the Nintendo console before, like y'all ladies have. Like, y'all are huge Zelda fans.
Right.
So, but from somebody that's looking from the outside, looking in, this game needs to be, like, it needs to launch with, the console needs to launch with Zelda. It just, I don't think it can just be a Mario from what I'm hearing. It's only going to be like one of the huge titles is only going to be a Mario. I don't think we know that for sure, but it needs something other than a Mario, man. The Zelda would really, really, really sell this thing.
Right. And I agree with both you ladies. I think that, as far as me, everybody knows it's not a secret. I'm one of the big, like one of the big Nintendo fans on the website. So when it comes down to like Nintendo and Zelda, like, I've invested a lot of my time talking about Nintendo on the website, as well as obviously being a gamer and a fan, as well as Erica too. Erica's a Nintendo fan as well. And it's like, especially when it comes down to Zelda, me and Erica, oh my God, when it comes down to Zelda, the love is real. So as for me, speaking, it's specifically for me, I'm interested in the Nintendo Switch. I think that it has the possibility of doing some very interesting things for Nintendo. I think that it's one of these kind of decisions, as far as the console itself, that Nintendo is honing on their strengths. They know that their strength is in handheld development and handheld gaming. And for them to turn their next console into a console handheld hybrid, I think it's genius. And I think that the Nintendo Switch has enough people's attention to where they have to make sure the launch library is just as enticing as that original preview. And the best way to do that is to launch it with Zelda. Like, there's a lot of rumors saying that, you know, that big 3D Mario game that was in the preview trailer is rumored to be one of the launch titles, as well as Skyrim, as well as, was it Splatoon, like a Splatoon remake or something like that. And all of those games sound great and good in theory, but at the end of the day, like the lady said, Zelda is what the people want. This is what we've been waiting for. We've been waiting on this game for literally years. I think it was back in 2014 when Aonuma at E3 snapped his fingers and showed us what the game looked like for the first time. And ever since then, people have been really, really wanting this game. So I think, but as far as the actual rumor itself, saying that it's rumored to come out at least by the summer, that is literally the latest it could come. It can't be like holiday 2017, like literally summer. And when I say summer, I mean like the tail end of May, like right. No later than that.
Because yeah, once E3 comes, and I hate to say it, but I love Nintendo, but once Microsoft does whatever they're going to do, Nintendo may be drowned out, so they need to get in where they can fit in.
I think they're gonna release it before E3 if they do, because Nintendo has been silent for a long time, and I think that that's in preparation for the Nintendo Switch. So I think that they're gonna release Zelda, and then once E3 comes, they're gonna be talking about Switch stuff. So I do think it's gonna come out before E3, but it cannot come out post May, and that's just me saying that because it's gonna get like Last Guardian status, and people are gonna stop caring, and they're gonna move on. So they need to bring this game out as soon as they possibly can. Anytime after May is gonna be too late. That's all I'm saying.
I wouldn't call it a Last Guardian. Like, people wouldn't care because I think Zelda has that fan base where people are gonna play Zelda whenever. It don't matter when. They're gonna buy it, but for the console itself, it needs some top tier game.
The console itself definitely needs Zelda.
Yeah, it can't just be Mario. I hate to say it, I love Mario, I'm a Mario fan, but it can't just be Mario, because even though like certain games are coming with it, and it has to have a certain amount of games and a lineup of games that entice a lot of different gamers. And some people are kind of getting tired of Mario. Mario sells and all that, but they want that Zelda, man.
Yeah, that's like that. I think that Mario's gonna be lit based on what we saw from the trailer. Yeah, but that's not what people want. That's not what people want right now.
Like a Nintendo 64 kind of Mario. Right,
but that's not that. But people want that, but they want Zelda now because we've been promised Zelda for years. People want Zelda now. But let's go ahead and transition over. I don't want to spend too much time on this topic. There's also another rumor that the Nintendo Switch is rumored to be $250 at launch. And I'm going to say my piece about it, and then I'm going to give you ladies the floor. But I think it's very probable that the Nintendo Switch is going to be $250 at launch, and this is why I feel the way that I feel. If you guys know anything about Nvidia, Nvidia has their Nvidia Shield tablet line, and they're selling their current Nvidia Shield right now for $200. So the Nintendo Switch is basically an Nvidia Shield tablet with a Nintendo logo on it. I think that the fact that it's $250, or it's rumored to be $250, is a very real possibility because of what Nvidia has already done. And the reason why I really stress Nvidia is because, even though, you know, this is a Nintendo console, like, Nvidia is very, very much behind this thing. They've been promoting this thing. This is not one of those type of situations where a person is just giving someone a chipset set to use. Nvidia is behind this thing all the way. They're powering this thing all the way. And there's no reason for me to believe that this is any different than any of Nvidia's current things they've already done. Not only that, but the fact that this thing is going to be a console handheld hybrid, Nintendo is going to want that price to be competitive with what they've already done with their handhelds. When the Nintendo 3DS came out, it was like $250 or something like that. The XL was around the same price. And I know that the new 3DS was also about $250. And I think that if it does launch at $250, that would be good for Nintendo, because that's what people expect something of this form factor to be priced at. Because of the portability of it, people are going to see it as more of a handheld than anything else. You know what I mean? And I think that if it could probably get away with $300, depending on, you know, some other things. Like, we don't know what's inside of it yet. We don't know what type of features it's going to have. But $250 is a great price, because not only is it already a product that people are interested in, and a cheap price is just gonna make people wanna buy into it even more. But the fact that it's gonna be undercutting the other consoles, so it's like, if it's cheaper, like, people are gonna be like, whatever, it's $250, I'll throw the money at it and call it a day. So what do you guys think about this rumor? Do you think it's true? Is it not true? Would you be willing to spend $250 on a Switch? I'll give the floor to Jaleesa.
Oh, to me, I feel like I kind of guessed at $300. I said, because Nintendo's, they're going to be the cheaper console no matter what. They're not going to be as expensive as the PS4 or the Xbox. So $250, $300, that's a great price. Especially depending on what games they put on it. And like you said, the NVIDIA Shield and how that architecture is and that Nintendo is working with them. And it's pretty a safe bet, I would say, between $250 and $300. And I don't think that's a bad price at all.
Yeah. What about you, Erica?
I was like Jaleesa. I originally thought $300. That was my guess. Mm-hmm. So that awkward moment when the Wii U is more expensive than this price. $250 is cheap to me.
Yeah, that's crazy cheap, yo.
Mm-hmm. And I'd pick it up, especially for Zelda. That's an easy decision to make. I just think that's a good, solid price. I hope it's true.
I hope so too.
We do. But like you're saying, I mean, it's going to come down to the games. And, you know, as far as the NVIDIA and all that, I'm not sure how powerful those things are, how powerful this is going to be.
Oh, they match what consoles are doing right now.
Nice.
Yeah, NVIDIA Shield is pretty dope. Like, when we saw it at PAX East, it was really dope. But now that I know they probably got things down pat and probably got better and better along past 2 years.
Yeah.
They're probably even better than they were when we saw them.
Yeah, because even the one that they're selling right now was, like, old. You know what I mean? So it's like,
yeah,
they've had time to develop some chipsets that can rival what's out. Like, and mobile technology is moving so rapidly. Like, oh, yeah.
Definitely.
Like, I don't think this thing is going to be, like, you know, Scorpio or anything like that. But I think it's gonna be comparable. That's all I'll say. I think it's gonna be comparable to like the base, not the Scorpio, Jaleesa.
I think this is gonna be better than the Wii U, which is just
It's gonna be better than the Wii U, of course. But I'm saying
it's gonna be look better than the Wii U. But that's not a bad thing either. Cause
yeah.
Art style in certain games.
Right.
Art style.
Yeah. When it comes to Nintendo, most fans, I would bet to say, they don't care that much about, oh, it has to be powerful, it has to be better than Xbox, better than PlayStation. No, it's about the games, and as long as the games are good, Nintendo fans are happy.
But I also do think, though, that it is going to be comparable to, like, at least the base Xbox One. That's what I'm saying.
I would hope so. I would think
so.
Yeah,
because
especially for the third party games.
Right. Because, like, I mean, based on everything that we've been saying, like, Bethesda has already said that they would not be supporting this thing unless it was at least as powerful as the Xbox One. So,
okay. Yeah.
Anyway, so let's go ahead and move on to Game Awards! So, this kind of slipped up on me. I'll be honest with you. The Game Awards is going to air on December 1st at what time? I thought I saw a time somewhere floating around here, but I don't.
Around the same time as PS.
I'm guessing 6 Pacific.
6 Pacific time, so it's like 6, 7, 8.
I don't know.
It'll probably be around 9 my time.
Yeah, okay. I would say 6 here.
It usually around like that. 8 to 9 o'clock Eastern time.
Yeah, I think it was like that last year.
Right. Yeah. I thought I saw somewhere it was like 8:30 Eastern or something like that. Yeah. I don't know. But we do know for sure that it will be airing on December the 1st. So that's in what, 2 weeks?
Yeah.
2 weeks.
I'm a little mad because I'm not going to PSX this year. And for people who actually bought PSX tickets, Sony updated their website basically saying that if you want to go to the Game Awards, it's a little, I think it's like maybe 20 more bucks.
2030.
Oh,
yeah. I have tickets. Yeah, I didn't even know.
You should have waited.
you can go back and I think add it on because
Well, shoot, you better go then. So let's go ahead and go through the all of the what do you call these?
Categories.
Brain fart. So let's go ahead and go through all the categories, and we could talk about the games in those categories, and then we could just kind of discuss and have some dialogue about them. So we're gonna start with Game of the Year. So this is for a game, and this is at GameSpot, by the way. This is where I'm getting my information from. For a game that delivers the absolute best experience across all creative and technical fields. So on the ballot are Doom, Inside, Overwatch, Titanfall 2, and Uncharted 4. So I'm gonna say, who do you think is going to get Game of the Year? Anybody?
Not necessarily we want.
Who do you think is gonna get it? And who do? Well, okay, we can do it this way. Who do you want to get Game of the Year? Who do you think is gonna get it?
Go for it, Jaleesa. What do you think?
Oh, y'all already know. Uncharted 4. Hopefully, is gonna win this easily. But, I will say that I think Doom and I think Overwatch may have a chance. Because I think Doom hit people out of nowhere, and it did better than expectations, because, you know, they had the whole, they wasn't giving out copies before the game came out.
Yeah.
So people were, like, mad worried. It's the same thing they did with Mafia 3. It's the same people, if I'm not mistaken. Not the same people, but the same kind of thing where, we're not sending the game out to all these outlets until the day of, and Doom, I think, may have a chance, but Uncharted 4 all the way. I beat it. I love it. It's a really good game. It still is, I think, in my top three for Game of the Year. But Overwatch as well, man. It's a highly publicized game. So for me, it's not a toss-up, but I can see if it doesn't win, I wouldn't be mad and be like, oh my god, it didn't win.
Yeah. What about you, Erica?
If I had to pick who I think is going to win, it's between, I think, Overwatch and Uncharted 4.
Yeah.
Well, you know what? I take that back. Inside, okay? I think Inside has a really good shot to win this.
Indies for the win?
Indie for the win.
That's Erica's new name.
No, I'm serious. It's widely praised. It's a game that a lot of journalists are talking about, and YouTube channels and things like that. I've played it. It's great. It's just short.
I think Inside would be a sleeper. I think it would be more of a journey, like a game that nobody saw coming, and then all of a sudden, like, oh my god, like, this game is actually beating out bigger titles.
Right.
At the same time,
it's the creators from Limbo. So we kind of expected this to be like trippy and good in that way. And I think it just blew the minds of people, especially the ending and stuff. I don't want to spoil it, but I think Inside has a solid chance to win it. But and that'll be my pick too, because I did enjoy the game. So yeah, I mean, I'm just kind of surprised by a couple of these, like Overwatch, I'm a little bit surprised. And Titanfall, I'm very surprised.
I am very surprised to see Titanfall.
Very, very surprised. Yeah.
I can't believe that's on the list.
I'm more surprised that there isn't one Microsoft game here. There's Forza Horizon 2. I would have thought Forza Horizon 2 might have made it, because it did very well.
As game of the year,
I'm just saying, rating wise, and from a lot of people that I know who not even just like racing games, but you know, it's not like Forza Motorsport. Horizon is more of a fun game. It's more of a race anywhere you want to type of game, and it rated very well. I think it's their top rated game.
I mean, I hear what you're saying, but as far as a game of the year type of game, game.
I've heard that from some people who think Forza Horizon is like in their top tier games for like game of the year.
I mean, I believe you, but I just can't see a racing game as a game of the year contestant. But that's just me, though.
I mean, Overwatch, I can see Gears Overwatch there. Has no type of story. It's just a shooter.
Yeah, that's true. That is also true. You are so right about that, and that is why I'm kind of puzzled that it's in there.
Yeah, that's what throws me off too, is Overwatch is just multiplayer only, you know?
Yeah.
And that, and Titanfall, the first one, got blasted for that, but yet Titanfall 2 is here. It just, it doesn't really...
It doesn't make sense.
It's weird.
It doesn't make any sense. I mean, and Titanfall 2 has a campaign this time around.
And it's good.
I've heard it's extremely good. But Overwatch, I think... It met expectations and then it over exceeded the expectations.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's true.
That's true.
I could see
I could see Gears being in here rather than Forza though.
Yeah, I could see Gears rather than Forza.
But I don't know, man. You know, sometimes it's always about the ratings that these games get too. Forza did highly well. I think it's their first 90 plus Metacritic score they've gotten the whole generation.
I mean, what Metacritic score did Doom? I know a lot of people like Doom, but did it really get that good of a Metacritic score?
Doom did extremely well, though. It did. It exceeded expectations from people.
Doom is like a sleeper of the year.
Yeah, Doom is a sleeper too.
Yeah.
Okay. I wish they had that category, but anyways.
Yeah, I mean, you can't always get what you want. But yeah, as far as me. I think that if out of all of these games, I think Uncharted should get it, because it's like Titanfall 2, it's good, but like I don't really think it's as storied as like Uncharted 4. Like I like the idea of the campaign and how they went with it and how they had the whole like sentient Titans, things like that. I thought that was really cool. But I think that Uncharted 4 should get Game of the Year. As far as Overwatch, fun game. The only reason why it's here is because it's popular. Otherwise, I honestly don't see how it's here. But, I mean, that's just my opinion. So, let's go ahead and move on. So, Best Game Direction. Recognizing a game studio for outstanding creative vision, game direction, and design. And so, we've got Blizzard for Overwatch, DICE for Battlefield 1, id Software for Doom, Naughty Dog for Uncharted 4, and then Respawn for Titanfall 2. And as far as game direction, I'm just gonna go ahead and say I think Battlefield 1 should take that one.
Ooh, nice choice.
Oh, that game is gorgeous.
Right?
Love the way that game looks. And the feel of it too, because when I first heard about Battlefield 1, like initially, I was like, I don't know if I really care about World War One. And then I played the beta and I was like, oh my lord. The way that they made that game, they really painted that picture of World War One, boy. I was like, whoa. This, like, the way that they just everything that they did, like the Zeppelins and then like just the art direction, everything, like you really felt that it was supposed to be a game set in that era, and yeah, I like that. So I say that I think Battlefield 1 should win that one.
I agree, but then also I talked to Char, shout out to Char, and she kind of opened my eyes to more things. She was saying, well, we've already seen Battlefield. Of course, it has a different paint job on it, you know, it's a different time period and all that. And that was the argument I was making, but she said, we've seen Uncharted, we've seen Titanfall. And Doom is kind of like a remastered, you know, kind of thing, revision.
Right.
But Overwatch is creative and it's new.
True.
It's a new franchise and the direction they went with it and all of that and the design of the characters and how they all mesh together and the art style and everything. And I thought about it, I'm like, you know, that's a good point. So I'm kind of going back and forth between Battlefield and Overwatch. Because Battlefield, yeah, we've played Battlefield before, but not like this.
Right.
Not this time period, not with these weapons, these sound effects.
The way they painted the picture, though, that's where I'm coming from.
Yeah, so I could be cool with either of those winning. That's just me, though. That's my picks. Jaylisa?
Y'all already know what I'm going to say. Naughty Dog is king. I will say this, man. Battlefield 1, it looks extremely freaking good, man. I'm with Neo on this one. Like, I did not know what to think of Battlefield 1. And not even the fact that we saw it at E3, because, you know, we was like, it's on PC, and we don't know how it's going to really look on consoles. But when we got the beta, yeah, that changed my mind, like, 10 to 1. I was like, oh, my God. Like, World War One looks so fun. Like, and even though it's a different type of guns, you got to get used to how everything plays because it's not like the same. It for a World War One game, a game from a time period we've never seen before, it did extremely well.
That's what I'm saying, man. That's what I'm saying.
Blizzard with Overwatch was something totally different when it comes to the aspect of how it plays, how it looks. It's a little different. It's not even a little different. It's a lot different. Character customization and the guns and the people you play with and how the colors, and it looks really colorful. And I'm not a huge fan of Overwatch, but I really do like the way it looks. It looks extremely good.
Yeah, it's got a good art style.
Yeah, the art style is extremely good. But when it comes to how a game looks in the direction that they went with the game, Uncharted 4 is freaking beautiful.
It is a beautiful game.
Yeah, I agree with
don't
that.
Don't get me wrong, it's gorgeous.
The first thing when Erica told me she saw the game at E3 and she was like, yo, the actual previews, whatever you've seen on the computer does not do this game any justice. Right. Erica was telling the truth.
when you see that on your TV, it's like, or monitor, whatever, it's just a whole step above.
Not even that, like, when you first play the game, like, dang, this looks really good. But once you get to Madagascar, oh my god.
Right. Hey, how long did you just stand there and look?
Oh, I stood there and took mad pictures.
Same here.
I had like 40 screenshots on my joint, like, of me just taking pictures. And then the way that they opened the game up more and gave you more of a, it was still kind of linear, but they gave you more open spaces to do more things within the game, I thought was interesting. Because, you know, Uncharted has never been an open game. It's always been very, very closed. It's like a, you go here, you go there, you gotta go through all these guys to get here. But they opened the game up a lot more than what I thought they were gonna do.
Yeah.
Especially like Madagascar was very open. The jungle scene where you have, like, it's a big jungle and you can figure, it's one way, how can I explain it? You're going one place, but you can go multiple ways to get to that one place.
Right.
And that game just looked masterful, man.
Right.
We'll get to that, though. There's still art direction. So
let's go ahead and go to best narrative. Okay, so for outstanding storytelling and narrative development in a game, and we have Firewatch, Inside, Mafia 3, Oxenfree, which I actually haven't heard of, and Uncharted 4. I haven't heard of Oxenfree.
I haven't either.
I don't know. I haven't heard great things about Firewatch. That's what happened last year. It's like, what is this?
But you know what I noticed about best narrative?
What?
No Telltale games.
What? That doesn't even make sense!
Yes, I was kind of surprised by that. Because I think the Machine game...
What all came out this year when it came to Telltale?
Batman,
Michonne.
I guess they weren't worthy. I mean,
that Minecraft game. I don't think people care about that too much. But still,
I guess Oxenfree was more worthy.
Oh yeah, that's crazy.
Just go and say my pick real quick. I'm picking Inside because it's your own self interpretation, and just the game is, it's just, it makes your mind go wild with ideas. Mm-hmm. I thought it was great, so that's my pick.
What about you, Jaleesa? You've played both Mafia 3 and Uncharted 4, so what do you think?
Yes, I have, and I'm picking Mafia 3. I think it's the best story I've played this year.
Yeah, why do you say that?
The gameplay is not there, the story, like, that's really what drives you to play and beat the game, is the story. Because it's more of a Assassin's Creed 2 type of story.
Mm-hmm.
A story on revenge, and, like, the story is really what makes you, like, go through the game, even though the gameplay is just so, oh my god, you're doing the same thing over and over again. But you're doing it over and over again to get to the next part of the story because the story is so good. And then you find out what happened to the guy from the last game in Mafia 2.
Because
there's, like, a cliffhanger at the end of that game. And you only learn about what happened to whoever, well, I ain't gonna say what, but you have to play along the game for a nice little minute before you figure out what happened to him. It's got an Assassin's Creed 2 feeling to it. So
yeah,
if any of y'all like Assassin's Creed 2 story, you will love Mafia 3's story. And that's, to be honest, the best thing about the game.
Right. Let's go ahead and move on to best art direction. And so we have Abzu, Firewatch, Inside, Overwatch, and Uncharted 4. For best art direction, I'm going to have to go with Overwatch.
Ooh, nice.
Like, Overwatch has the art direction, and I know we talked about game direction, and that's why I say Battlefield 1 had a really good game direction. Because it wasn't just about the art style, it was about the game in general, really making you feel like you were in World War 1. So, yeah, so that's my pick. What about y'all?
Elisa?
Art direction.
Did we even ask?
No, I'm actually not going to pick Uncharted for this one, even though it looks like it's fantastic. No, I'm not.
Erica, oh, wow.
I actually like Inside and Abzu. Ooh.
Yeah, Abzu's a pretty game,
too. Now we're talking. Yeah, that was my pick.
Abzu. I'm not going to pick Uncharted.
Abzu's very pretty. It's a very pretty
game. Uncharted is an incredible looking game, but when it comes to art style, it's not like we haven't seen Uncharted before.
Yeah.
Abzu is a beautiful game. And Inside is very like the art style is extremely different. So I like both of those games.
Mm-hmm.
Overwatch is pretty good too. I did like their overall art style for that game as well. But I think Abzu and Inside are probably my top two.
Right.
Yeah. Those two with Overwatch, those are good. Either one I'd be cool with.
Right.
They deserve it. So best indie.
Yes, indies for the win.
Let's go.
All right, so let's go ahead and move on to best independent game for outstanding achievement in a game made outside of the traditional publisher system. We've got Firewatch, Hyper Light Drifter, Inside, Stardew Valley, and The Witness. I'm going to let Indies for the Win answer this one.
I knew it was coming. I knew it.
What do you think, Erica?
All day, you guys, because Fury is not in this list.
Whoa.
Fury.
I forgot about that game.
I would have left off The Witness and put Fury on there.
Well, maybe that Stardew? I don't even know what that really is. Like, I've looked it up.
It's kind of like a Harvest Moon in, like, 2D or something like that.
Yeah, but I didn't play it, so, I mean... But yeah, if I could, I would just squeeze Fury in here.
I'm just gonna say Hyper Light Drifter, because I know Char was, like, super hyped for that game, so it must be awesome.
I played it. It's good. It's awesome. That's
I my still need. Too. I still need to get that game, BTW, because yeah. I was Inside looking forward great. To that, too.
Yeah, Inside is great, but it's just short, like I was saying. Mm-hmm. But
I haven't played any of these, but if I had to pick one, I probably would say from watching you play it and a couple other people that I know who have Xbox One play it, Inside looked really fun. So I would say Inside, even though it's extremely short, it looks like it's fun. And I watched you play it and a couple other people play it.
Yeah.
Nice. Did you play Limbo? Or no?
I did not play The Witness. I'm not like a puzzle gamer type of person, but some people told me that The Witness is good if you into those type of games.
Right.
But did you play Limbo though, Jaleesa?
A little bit. I played it on Vita though.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. But so I kind of have an idea.
Yeah, I kind of have an idea of like what kind of game it is, even though I haven't played it. But it looks like I think Inside seemed like a really good game. Hyper Light Drifter, I've heard of that game, but I haven't seen people playing it. But I've heard of it before.
Right,
Nia, you got to play it. If you love Zelda, you got to play this.
Yeah, no, and I think like I didn't back it on Kickstarter because I was poor. But, like, I saw it on Kickstarter, and I was like, yo, this game looks like it's going to be dope.
Yeah, I haven't heard nobody like Firewatch. Like, nobody like Walking Simulator? Like,
anytime I've heard anybody say anything about Firewatch, they said that it was overhyped garbage.
Mm-hmm. Negative
if,
stuff.
If that's me keeping it real, like, I'm not trying to say it, because, I mean, I don't know. I didn't play the game. But anybody that I've heard talk about the game who've played it, it's not as great. Yes. Yeah. People try.
I heard it's very overhyped.
So, best mobile game. All right. Oh. So, we've got Clash Royale, Fire Emblem Fates, Monster Hunter Generations, Pokemon Go, and Severed. Oh my god, if Pokemon Go wins, I'm gonna be so mad.
Oh man.
Wow. If Pokemon Go wins, I'm gonna be so mad.
I would not be surprised if it does, though.
Pokemon Go is barely a game.
I play it all the time. That game is fun.
And you actually play Pokemon. You should be ashamed of yourself.
Oh.
I'm sorry. I play Pokemon Go on the regular during summertime. I am not ashamed of telling anybody that. We would go walk, like me and my cousin would go walking in the afternoon and walking to Pokemon's edge. And yes,
get it how you live. I'm just saying, like,
hey, Pokemon Go is addictive. And people was like, oh, it's dead. No, do you know how many people still play that game? It's still in the top 10 on the App Store. Oh. So it's not dead.
That's crazy. Yeah, it's still in the top 10. That's crazy.
And but I will say this, though, I have Fire Emblem Fates. So I've played that game and actually it's a really good game.
Fire Emblem is life, yeah.
Yeah, that was my first Fire Emblem game, so I would say Fire Emblem and Pokemon Go.
Yeah, if you ever get a chance, pick up Awakening. Awakening is great. Great. But y'all already know if I had to choose, Monster Hunter should win.
Monster Hunter, yeah, I figured.
But that's just my opinion. So let's
see. I didn't play any of these, so I mean, yeah. Whatever wins.
Whatever wins, wins.
Shame on you.
So let's go ahead and move on to best action game. So we've got Battlefield 1, Doom, Gears of War 4, Overwatch, and Titanfall 2. I'm going to say Gears should win this because all of these other games are in other categories, and Gears needs a W. Microsoft needs a W because this is like their only game other than Forza that's even in the running for anything.
I still think they're not going to win this one.
I don't think they are too, but I think they should.
I think Battlefield 1 is going to take this one.
You know what? I could see that too.
I could see that.
I'm not saying anything about Gears 4 being a bad game at all, though. But I don't think they're going to win this one. I think it would be my number two. And I think Battlefield 1 probably would be number one for me. But you never know. Freaking Overwatch might come out of the blue and kill everyone.
That's so true.
You never know, because Overwatch could win all of this stuff. We don't even know.
Because everybody is still pumped up on Overwatch.
Yeah, it's still going strong. Way strong.
It's never like below top five on Twitch.
That's so true. Oh my gosh. That's so true.
Yeah, but when I think action, I think single player, explosions, action going on, like,
true.
You know what I mean? So I feel like Gears has a good chance, but Doom is in there too.
Right.
Doom has a lot of action, so this can go either way,
yeah.
Honestly, between those two and even Battlefield too.
What's kind of funny, we haven't seen Call of Duty yet.
It's not in here at all.
That is a good point.
I was saying earlier with Char, I'm like, we're evolving.
That
we're
is
doing
a
it.
Good point, Jaleesa.
No,
we're not
evolving. They couldn't add Call of Duty.
One could hope.
That is a good point. Oh my god.
Yeah. So.
Crazy. All right, so let's go ahead and move on to best action adventure game. So we've got Dishonored 2, Hitman, Hyper Light Drifter. I can't believe that made it to the list. Holy crap. Ratchet and Clank and Uncharted 4. I vote for Ratchet and Clank all day.
And I'm voting for that one as well.
All day.
I just started it, but it's cool.
All day. Ratchet and Clank is how you do a remake, okay? Like, Ratchet and Clank, everybody's all like, why do I need to play Ratchet and Clank? I've already played the PS2 game. Like, first of all, it's not the original, okay? It is a hodgepodge of everything that is Ratchet and Clank in one game, and it is a retelling of Ratchet and Clank, guys. It is a remake in its fullest, dudes. You need to pick it up if you can. Yeah. It's great. And I'm gonna leave it at that.
I hope it wins.
I want it to win.
Eric, I'll let you go first before I say my piece.
Well, I was just gonna say I just started this game a couple days ago, so I'm not too far in, but so far I've seen puzzles. The graphics are or pretty.
Oh my gosh, so pretty.
It's a cool game. It's cool. So I could see this winning. If not that, then Hyper Light Drifter. I'm down with that winning. But as far as puzzles, it's not like a crazy puzzle game. So
yeah,
it's basically kind of like a Zelda. Kinda.
Yeah.
Zelda Fury-ish mesh kind of thing. Mm-hmm. It's cool. So either one of those, I'll pick.
Yeah, see, I know Dishonored 2, I can't even give a true assessment of that game because I haven't played it. I haven't seen gameplay of it.
Me neither.
But I heard it's actually doing extremely well ratings-wise. I know a lot of people is rating it pretty high. But for me, it would have to be Ratchet & Clank, man. Sorry, Uncharted.
Yes.
Even though Uncharted is a fantastic game, but Ratchet & Clank was like such a fantastic palate cleanser.
Yes.
It's one of those games where you're just having fun. It's not like a
it doesn't take yourself so serious.
You're trying hard, yeah.
And it was a great palate cleanser. It was just a fun game. You know how like game that came out what is the name? South Park. No, like South Park, you really don't take
it's just
the game,
a fun so. Game.
Yeah, it's just a fun game. And you need those every now and again to it's like a palate cleanser, basically. A game that's really good, but you don't really take it that serious.
Right. Jaleesa feels my heart right now, yo. She preaching to me right now.
Both of y'all know I wasn't the hugest fan of this game.
Yes, Jaleesa, you see the lights.
Oh, the fact that I am still not a fan of the PS3 Ratchet and Clank.
Girl, bye.
I screwed that, but PS1 joints. I love those games. I love Ratchet and Clank at the beginning. But I just thought they was just doing a little too much with the Into the Nexus and all those
hey,
games.
Hey, hey, hey. You will not, ma'am.
After I played this game at PSX, it changed my mind dramatically.
I'm telling you.
I was there.
Graphically, art style-wise, the game looks freaking gorgeous.
This is what Ratchet & Clank... Listen to what she said, right? This is what Ratchet & Clank does to the people, guys. Ratchet and Clank is the truth. I'm trying to tell you. But let's go ahead and move on to Best RPG. And this category got me kind of hyped because I see one of my favorite games is in this book. So let's go ahead and get into it. Dark Souls 3, Deus Ex, Mankind Divided, Witcher 3, Wild Hunt, World of Warcraft Legion, and Xenoblade Chronicles X. Oh my god, that game is literally life.
So we know your answer, right?
You already know my answer. Xenoblade Chronicles X was my life for 2 months. 2 months, dudes. 2 months.
I heard you didn't even shower. That's how bad it was.
Oh my god. See, we're not gonna go that far, but let me say I did stay up so many nights playing this game, looking at strategy guides. Yo, damn. This game was my life. You know how you were with Bloodborne, Erica? This was my Bloodborne. This game consumed me, Erica. I don't think you understand.
Absolutely. No, I believe it. Because once you said it's for Bloodborne, say no more. Say no more. I got you.
Oh my god. So, I know this game is probably not going to win. But.
I think Bloodborne told Erica to like.
Oh, yeah. That was my life last year.
Oh my god. Xenoblade was definitely.
You should already know my answer then, right?
Your answer is gonna be Dark Souls.
Yeah, of course. This is the only category it got any love. It's not nominated.
That's crazy.
So I was surprised by that, but I don't know, man. At the same time, I feel like if it was up for Game of the Year, I don't think it would win.
Yeah,
just because it
so
just
many heavy hitters.
Like
yeah,
Bloodborne didn't get it last year, so I'd imagine this one wouldn't either. But,
right.
But yeah, definitely my best RPG. But to be fair, I didn't play the others, so
yeah,
you know, it is what it is. But I wouldn't say Dark Souls 3 was my life, but I did put tons of time into it. It's good.
Yeah,
it's really good.
I feel you. What about you, Jaleesa?
For me, I'm not a huge Dark Souls fan. Xenoblade, I never played that game. World of Warcraft, meh. I would say DSX, but I haven't played the new one yet, so right. I can't say good or bad. I played the one before that, and that one was excellent. That was like my game of the year for that year. Mm-hmm. So I would have to say Witcher 3.
Witcher 3, okay, we got it.
It could win. It could.
Even though I did not finish it, it just overwhelmed me, man. That game over. I ain't even gonna lie and be like, oh well, I'll finish it. Nah, that game overwhelmed me a little bit.
Right.
There's a lot to do,
but it's not a bad game by any means. Mm-hmm. It was just so much to do.
Right. So let's go ahead and move on to best sports racing. So we've got FIFA 17. Forza Horizon 3, MLB The Show 16, NBA 2K17, and Pro Evolution Soccer. And Jaleesa, since you are our sports enthusiast, I'm going to give you the floor first.
Well, for me, Microsoft might have a shot in this one. Mm-hmm. Forza Horizon 3 actually may win this one, but 2K17 did way better than a lot of people thought they were going to do this year. They added a whole lot more. The game overall is a better experience, and I think it's the best sports game to come out this year. Mm-hmm. And that's over MLB, FIFA. And I think a lot of people who play soccer would probably say Pro Evolution this year is way better than FIFA too.
Oh yeah, I've been hearing, and you know, I've never really heard people talk about Pro Evolution Soccer as much as I have this year. Usually it's all about FIFA, and there's usually no room for anybody else. But I'm actually kind of surprised by how many people I've heard raving about Pro Evolution Soccer in place of FIFA. So even though I'm not really into sports games, I have noticed that has been a thing that I've noticed with people who are into like the sports genre. So I could see that too.
Me, I'm not like a soccer fan either, but you know, I've kind of picked since I'm into sports games and stuff. And you, like you said, people, I know that, like, I live around a bunch of people who are from Liberia, and I used to work with a lot of them too, and they love FIFA. But this year, I haven't really heard them say anything about FIFA. It's all Pro Evolution Soccer.
Yeah.
They don't care nothing about the stuff they added in FIFA. It was like, they didn't fix the game. And it was like, Pro Evolution is actually a better game.
Right.
But if I had to pick one to win, I think Forza and 2K are probably top two.
Oh yeah, I agree with you. Forza, it's gonna be between Forza and 2K, I think, this year. What do you think, Erica?
I'm giving Microsoft a W on this one.
Forza's gonna take it, you think?
Forza. Yeah, I think it should. Well, I mean, I can't.
Do you have Horizon 3?
Yeah, I have it.
Yeah,
it's beautiful, awesome game. I just need to put more time into it. I've been slacking because there's just too many freaking games, man.
Yeah.
But it handles well. Like, the cars are all different. It's just, oh, it's awesome.
That's awesome.
And
that's,
I'm not awesome, even like a racing gamer kind of gamer, you know. But it's a good game.
Yes. So let's go ahead and move on to best multiplayer, and then we're gonna do most anticipated game, and then we're gonna end it because this podcast is getting really long. So for best multiplayer game, we've got Battlefield 1, Gears of War 4, Overcooked, Overwatch, Titanfall 2, and Tom Clancy's Rainbow Six Siege. I am kind of biased because me and some of the people at SheAttack had a chance to play Overcooked this year, and it is awesome! Oh my god, I can't believe I had so much fun. I can't believe I had that much fun playing a competitive cooking game. It is so fun. And I think a lot of the reason why it's so fun is because it's so over the top to be a cooking game. Like, the stakes are so high and it's just a cooking game. And then you have to rely on, you know, the cooperation of yourself and your teammates, and that just adds to the overall fun in general. Overcooked is a sleeper, y'all, and I am so happy that it, you know, snuck itself inside of the best multiplayer game for Game of the Year, because that's gonna give it some notoriety. This game is really fun. But as far as what I think is gonna win, it's gonna be Overwatch all the way.
Yeah,
best multiplayer, Overwatch got it, y'all. What y'all think?
I agree with with your picks. But I was gonna say Overcooked looks really fun. I haven't played it, but it looks like a cool game to play with like your family,
yeah,
or like your siblings or something, your so husband fun. Or whatever. But yeah, I want Battlefield to win, but I do think Overwatch is gonna take this.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I just don't see Gears winning this. I don't see Titanfall winning this. No. Rainbow Six Siege is kind of that sleeper that's yeah. in there. Mm-hmm. You know, people, it's been selling, I think, more as time goes by. Mm-hmm. People are jumping on it.
So this game has legs. That's good.
It's got legs. Yeah, definitely. But I think Overwatch has way longer legs. Mm-hmm. This game's going to go for a while. So that's my pick, Overwatch.
What about you, Jaleesa?
For me, it's either Overwatch or Battlefield. I think Battlefield may win it, but, you know, the legs thing, like you were saying, yes. both of those have, like, people know once you get a Battlefield game, the game is going to have at least a 2-year leg cycle.
Oh, yeah.
At least, and to be honest, people are still playing Battlefield 4.
Mm-hmm.
Even though Battlefield 1 just came out, Battlefield 4 still has mad people online. So I think it's between Battlefield or Overwatch. Never played Overcooked, but it sounds like it's really good. Titanfall 2, nah, I don't think it's gonna win. Siege is actually a game that is a sleeper that I think, like y'all were saying before, it has a little bit of legs and it's some longevity. And once it started to get from that bumpy first couple weeks that it had, because you know it was having a little bit of issues and stuff like that, and it's a competitive, it's more of a team-based type of game. It's not just like straight team deathmatch. Like, you just can't be going in there thinking you're going to be Rambo.
Yeah. Like, I noticed that when I played the beta. Yeah, you ain't finna just go up and Rambo.
You're going to get murdered trying to play it that way.
Yes.
So I think either Overwatch or Battlefield 1. I would say for me, it would be Battlefield 1. But if Overwatch 1, I wouldn't be mad at all.
Yeah.
Because it's the popular.
I think it's between Battlefield and Overwatch 2. So I agree with you guys. So let's go ahead and move on to most anticipated game. An upcoming game that has shown significant ambition and promise in moving the gaming medium forward. So we've got God of War. We've got Horizon Zero Dawn, Mass Effect Andromeda, Red Dead Redemption 2, and The Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild. All of these are just golden games. Oh my God. This is...
Microsoft gets the snub again.
Ooh. What Microsoft games would be on the list? What Microsoft games do you think should be on the list?
Maybe, I don't think it should be, but Crackdown, I guess, could be Crackdown. One. Scalebound?
Scalebound.
I was going to say Scalebound. I'd
either probably put Scalebound.
What's the name of that game that's like the 50s cartoon game?
Cuphead! Oh my God, Cuphead!
That's one of my most anticipated.
I am so looking forward to Cuphead.
I'm looking forward to Cuphead too. I'm like, damn.
Yeah.
I think Rockstar or Mass Effect just came and took the sale out of one of those Microsoft games.
I'm telling you, I am so looking forward to Mass Effect. Oh my God, I hope that I have this new job by the time Mass Effect, because I need that game. That's all I'm going to say.
I'm hoping I get this new job as well before February.
Yes, ma'am. But all of these games are really good prospects. Like, this God of War looks great. Horizon, oh, that's in my top. Horizon's in my top. Mass Effect's in my top. Red Dead, I might try out. I'm not as excited for it because I didn't really play. I haven't played a Red Dead before. The Legend of Zelda, of course, is in my top. Like, as far as who I think is going to win... And who I think deserves the win, I'm going to say Horizon. I think that Horizon is one of, like, the most fresh out of all of these. Because even though God of War looks great, it doesn't look like anything we've never seen before from any other game. I'll just be honest with you. Mass Effect, I think, is going to be great, but I think it's just going to be Mass Effect. Mm-hmm. Red Dead, I don't know, because that trailer didn't really show a whole lot. And Zelda, while I think that Zelda's gonna be amazing and it's definitely gonna be like a day one buy for me, like, I don't really think that a lot of people care about Zelda, but at the same time a lot of people don't care about Zelda, if that makes sense. So I don't think that one is gonna get it, even though, you know, a lot of people are looking forward to it. I don't really think, in comparison to all of these other games, I think that people will probably draw more towards the others. So if I had to guess, Horizon all day. And I wouldn't be mad because Horizon looks amazing and I can't wait to get my hands on it. So I give the floor to y'all. Erica, who do you want? Which do you want to win and which do you think will win?
Who do I? Man, all of them I want to win.
I want all of these.
I want all of them, yeah. I was saying that earlier too. Like, damn.
It's such really a good list. Oh my gosh.
I do agree with you. You kind of like talked me into it. I think Horizon will win. I think they will because, I mean, people have been looking forward to that game for a while now. Mm-hmm. It's got a lot of hype. It's coming sooner than later compared to the rest. And yeah, I mean, if it does come out on time, that's what, February?
Oh yeah.
So that's already here. The hype is through the roof for this game.
Like, we're right there.
Yeah, so I could see Horizon getting this. If not Horizon, then probably Red Dead. Even though we haven't seen a lot, I mean, the first one was amazing.
It was so the first one was so good that it could carry the weight into the sequel.
Definitely. And yeah. It's Rockstar.
The first one is so good that Rockstar just put a logo up and people
pretty much
freaked their minds. So
they put a red background with the Rockstar logo in,
and everybody knew what was going on. Yeah. That's crazy.
And I agree with you on Zelda. You know, we really want it, but does everyone else? You know, it's kind of one of those things. And Mass Effect, I think, that could win too. But I'm going with Horizon. I think Horizon's gonna win.
Yeah. What do you think, Jaleesa?
Well, for me, I'm not like out of y'all. I'm not a huge Mass Effect fan. I didn't buy Mass Effect 3, but I did like Mass Effect 2. Mass Effect 2 was cool.
Yeah.
I didn't play 3.
Yeah, I feel you.
And I played 2. Zelda, like I said, I never really played Zelda except for Majora's Mask.
Majora's Mask, yeah.
Yeah, I played that one. That was my first.
You Zelda. Played the most offshoot Zelda ever to be that like your first Zelda.
No wonder you don't like Zelda.
I don't know about that one. But I'm actually excited about what I saw at E3. It looks kind of cool.
Yeah, I think it's going to be great.
Y'all said, man, it's Horizon and Red Dead. Because God of War, we really don't know if it's dropping next year. So I have faith in Santa Monica, but I just don't know if that game is going to drop next year. So I'm thinking who is going to win. I think Horizon is going to win.
Right.
The game looks freaking amazing.
And not only that, it's a new IP.
Right.
Exactly.
It's a new IP.
Fresh. So that curiosity is
yes.
up to, you know?
And then Guerrilla has a lot to show people this time around because, you know what I'm saying, Killzone 3 did not do as what people thought it was going to do. And this is fresh, a clean slate for Guerrilla.
Unknown
territory for them.
I'm
excited because I feel like every developer needs that one game where it's something completely different and letting people know that they can do something different.
Right.
Because I think all people who are gamers, we want to see developers try something different. You know what I'm saying? To show their talent. Because if you're doing the same thing over and over again, I think that's great. But when you show that you have multi-talent and you can do other things, it shows your creative ability and that you aren't stuck in a bubble.
Right.
So true. I think Horizon is going to win, but that Red Dead, man.
So Red Dead is who you want to win, and Horizon is who you think is gonna win.
They snuck in, man. Red Dead snuck in and was like, we're here, right? And then they just went away. Like, we won't hear nothing about Red Dead till probably freaking June of next year.
Mm-hmm. So Red Dead is who you want, but you think Horizon is gonna win? Is that what you're saying?
I want Horizon to win.
Okay.
I think they're going to win, but if they don't, Red Dead for sure.
Okay.
Okay. But I think Horizon, it's earned the right, I think, for a most anticipated game. Mm-hmm. It's right around the corner. I think that's one game that isn't going to be pushed back. I think if it does get pushed back, only reason why is because of Pro. But I don't think it's going to. Did y'all see it running on the Pro?
No, I haven't.
Color-wise, like, if you watch E3, and then you watch what they showed on the Pro, that game looks freaking fantastic.
Yeah, I think it's well deserved as well. So guys, that's all of the topics that we have for tonight. Thank you guys for coming through. I forgot to tell you guys that we finally have our shop up and running. If you want to go and buy a She Attack shirt, You can go and visit our shop at shop.spreadshirt.com/SheAttack. And we've got some cool stuff coming, man. We're just getting our shop started, but we will be having more things on our shop for you guys to go and purchase and support. And of course, we'll be letting you guys know what's going to be happening whenever those things do come. Don't forget to follow us on our social media. We have Facebook, we have Twitter, we have Instagram. Pretty much anything that you use, we do have it. If you have any questions, comments, or you know anything that you might want us to talk about or address on the show, make sure you tweet it to us. Make sure you put it down in the comment section below. We didn't do a bonus stage today because we did not have any questions coming our way. So just let us know. You know, anything you want us to talk about, we can talk about it. We took a lot of time today to talk about the Game Awards. Let us know what you think about the Game Awards. And then when we come back on in a couple of weeks and we talk about the results, maybe we can dialogue about it when we find out who actually is going to win these awards. It's Nia and I am out. I'm going to let my team leads go ahead and close out. Ladies, Erica, tell the people bye. Anything you want to say?
Well, that's pretty much it. Thanks for hanging in there. This is a long episode.
This is really long.
We went through a lot of categories and stuff. So thank you so much for listening. Stay tuned for the next one, and I'm out.
What's going on, everybody? Thanks for all of you for listening to level 2 of a podcast. Hopefully y'all enjoy, and hopefully y'all enjoy the Game Awards, and hopefully y'all send us feedback and actual questions to answer for level 3.
Yeah, for sure. All right, you guys. Peace.